Hi everyone, we are two AI engineers that work in Larus, and today we will talk about recommendations using graphs for sure, using Neo4j better. And as you can see, the full code is hosted on GitHub, so you can try this notebook and see the results. So we start downloading the dataset, and as you can see, this dataset is hosted on Kaggle and is a competition offered by H&M. So we download the dataset in which we have articles and customers. And for sure, these articles are bought by some customers both articles. To import the dataset, the major topic today is Apache Arrow. I don't know if all of you know Apache Arrow, but it's Apache Arrow. It's a standard to organize things in memory. We can say in a few words. And today we will use mainly Flyte, Apache Arrow Flyte, that is a protocol to send data around on the network. And as we will see, it's very, very fast, especially compared to the standard network, to the standard Neo4j driver, or in general to all the drivers that need to do serialization and deserialization. Okay, the first thing to do is to connect using the client to the server exposed by Neo4j. That is a new feature offered by Neo4j. And then we can list all the actions. And we see that we can create graph and create a database. The major difference is that with create graph, we create an in-memory graph, and with create database, we create a standard database. And to create a database, we have to assign a name for sure, and to follow some step in sequence. And the first step is to load the node, and after we have run the command to start the import, we load the nodes that are the articles and the customers. And there are the timing, as we can see, only o dot choose seconds to load 100,000 of articles, and I don't remember the exact number of customer, but the total number of nodes are something around 1 million and a half, as you can see. And with only 1 second, we have uploaded on Neo4j all the nodes. Then we have to load the relationships. So the transactions and the thing to do in this case is Neo4j can work only with integer ID, but we had string ID on the customer side. So with using this join and some steps, we created an integer ID also for the customer. And then we uploaded also the transaction, and only with 11 seconds plus other 18 seconds, so for a total of half a minute, we loaded something about 31 millions of transactions. So in A very little time, we uploaded a lot of nodes and relations. We are talking about not a giant graphs, but medium-large graphs for sure. Then we create recommendations using also the new features offered by Neo4j, that is the link predictions pipeline, and then we also use these graphs on memory, as we will see, to train a graph neural network. So the first thing to do is to project the graph, and so because as you know, only the graph in memory we can run, only on the graph in memory we can run graph data science algorithm, and also the link predictions work on the GDS library. So then we create the pipeline. So the full pipeline is we create the node embedding using fast random projection, that is a very fast algorithm to create node embeddings. Then we create the relationship embedding using the Hadamard product to get a vector on the relationships. And then with this Hadamard features created for sure as the product, the Hadamard product from the FastRP node embeddings, we trained a logistic regression, as we can see. Then for sure we have also to explicit the train fraction, test fraction, and validation faults to train the model, as in general we do in machine learning and AI. Then we added the logistic regression, and we can run the train pipeline. It's not so good as we can see from the results, but this is not the focus for today, because we want only to show how easily we can train, how easily and fast we can, and quickly we can train models to do recommendations using a full pipeline on Neo4j, and also using graph neural networks, especially Deep Graph Library that Valerio will present to us.
Thank you, Filippo. So as we said, we can use Apache Arrow to import data, but also to export data very fast. So if we want to use external Python library that exploit, for example, graph neural network, the like of DGL, as we will show, or PyTorch Geometric, we can do it very fast with Apache Arrow. So in our case, after we did the pipeline inside the GDS, we did another projection. This time we had to add a property to the relationship in order to extract it with Apache Arrow. We will build the FastRP embedding, and then we export the nodes with the procedure GDS graph node property stream, and we export all the embeddings for all the nodes in like 2 seconds, which is really, really fast. And at the same time, we export the relationship with the procedure GDS graph relationship property stream. This time we took 7 seconds, but we have the table with all nodes and relationship in really seconds. After we have the tables, we had to reindex the elements for the GL. So we had to join the relationship table with the nodes table and reindex the nodes. And once we have done that, we just get the source ID, the targets ID, and we create the graph with the GL. We took like 3 minutes to do so. And then we print the graph and we can see all the nodes and the number of relationships that are doubled because we projected the relationships as undirected. So it prints the relationship in both ways. Once we have the DDGL graph, we can just use the library as it's supposed to be used. So we create neighbor sampler for the positive graph, a negative sampler for the negative links, and we create a data loader in order to iterate over the data in order to give input to the model. We then create a simple stochastic two-layer graph convolutional network, and a score predictor that is just the dot product of the embedding of the network in order to see the probability between a customer buying an article. And in the model, we have as input the positive graph and the negative graph sampled with the sampler that we have defined before. And once we have the positive score and negative score, we use the predictor and we return in order to calculate the loss. And then it's just a simple iteration over just 5 epochs because we don't want to focus on performance but just to show how easily we can use data with GDS, but also for other libraries in Python. So we just, make a simple iteration. We just see that the loss is decreasing just for 5 epochs. Just to show how easily we created embedding on GDS and we downloaded all the entire graph in seconds and use it on DGL. So I think we have like 3 times for questions. So
This is as you can see, Apache Arrow and this feature released by Neo4j, it's really a game changer when you have to import or export a full graph to then train a graph neural network or create embeddings with other techniques different from those offered by Neo4j GDS library. So it's very an interesting feature.
Yeah, as for the memory, it doesn't require more memory than the Python driver of Neo4j, so it's just the same. Data transferred in binary format, so it's just equal memory footprint, I think, of the driver.
We have 2 minutes, and we think it's maybe a lot of stuff. Can you elaborate on
What is necessary to prepare? So we use the Python driver for Apache Arrow, the PyArrow library, but you can do the same thing with any language. So because Apache Arrow has libraries in Java, Go, and other languages. So you just have to create the token with the user and the password encoded in UTF-8 because Apache Arrow runs on HTTP 2.1, so it's all binary. You create the options just with authorization and the token, and then you can connect to the port that Neo4j offer for its Apache Arrow Flight server. You can do that with gRPC plus TCP or gRPC plus TLS if you use socket layer security. And Yeah, that's all you need. Once you have the client, you can just do the simple action with the commands, which are, for example, you create the action, you do action, but you have the client also to do put, to do, for example, for this stream, like here. Yeah, you create a ticket. Sorry, yeah, Philippe.
Yeah, because the question is how do I have to prepare the data to import it to the database? So it's mainly focused on which data pre-processing steps we need to carry about.
The same for the GDS. So for now, you have to use numeric data. So it's just the same of what you should do for a projection on the GDS.
Yeah, it's the same, but for sure Neo4j will extend this also to string and text because it's needed. So it's only because all these features presented in this notebook, I mean, a lot of these features are in alpha or beta stage. So it's under development, and for sure we will see a lot of updates. And so.
Yeah.
I don't know if we have time or we have to close, because I don't remember. I remember that we have the 15 minutes.
Yes, so if there are no other questions, then we can close this session. So thank you so much, Valerio.
For sure, you can reach us on LinkedIn or also in the chat of the event. So we will try.
Yeah.
Cool.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.